This is Lavita Media's Saint of the Day for November 12th. Today we celebrate Saint Josepha. In 1964, newspaper photos of Pope Paul VI embracing Athenagoras I, the Orthodox Patriarch of Constantinople, marked a significant step toward the healing of a division in Christendom that has spanned more than 9 centuries. In 1595, the Orthodox Bishop of Belarus and 5 other bishops representing millions of Ruthenians sought reunion with Rome. John Kuncevic, who took the name Josaphat in religious life, was to dedicate his life and die for the same cause. Born in what is now Ukraine, he went to work in Vilno and was influenced by clergy adhering to the 1596 Union of Brest. He became a Basilian monk, then a priest, and soon was well known as a preacher and an ascetic. He became bishop at a relatively young age and faced a difficult situation. Most monks, fearing interference in liturgy and customs, did not want union with Rome. By synods, catechetical instruction, reform of the clergy and personal example, however, Josaphat was successful in winning the greater part of the Orthodox in that area to the Union. But the next year, a dissident hierarchy was set up, and his opposite members spread the accusation that Josaphat had gone Latin, and all people following him would have to do the same. He was not enthusiastically supported by the Latin bishops in Poland. Despite warnings, he went to a place which was a hotbed of trouble. Attempts were made to foment trouble and drive him from the diocese. A priest was sent to shout insults to him from his own courtyard. When Josaphat had him removed and shut up in his house, the opposition rang the town hall bell and a mob assembled. The priest was released, but members of the mob broke into the bishop's home. Josaphat was struck with a halberd, then shot and his body thrown into the river. It was later recovered and is now buried in St. Peter's Basilica in Rome. He was the first saint of the Eastern Church to be canonized by Rome.